This is Mike from MinIO. In today's video, we're going to show you how to install and run MinIO on Debian-based systems using the CLI. At the end of this video, you'll be able to download the MinIO Debian package, launch the MinIO server, access the MinIO server using the browser, as well as install the MinIO client and attach to the local server that you just brought up and running. Also note that we've included documentation links here in the slides, as well as down in the description if you want to follow along. And you can see the documentation page here. All of the commands are here in the documentation, so please feel free to follow along. All right, so here we are on the Ubuntu server. As this is Debian-based, I wanted to show that to you by catting out the etc/os release command. First thing we're gonna do is download the Debian package for this OS. And we'll save this as minio.deb. Next thing we will do is use dpackage to install this package. So now that that's done, we will create a directory for MinIO to store its files. And as simple as that, we are ready to start running the server. In this command, we'll type MinIO server, indicating that directory we just created as the place where we want it to store the files, and using the console address of 9090. As you can see, it's up and running now, and it's giving me the credentials as well as a link to log into the web UI. Let's go ahead and do that now. Now that the server is up and running, let's go ahead and go to the IP address and port provided in the console and log in using the credentials. And now that we're in, let's go ahead and create a bucket. And just to make sure that everything's working properly, let's go ahead and upload a file. All right, so now that that file upload is complete, let's go back over to the console and see if we can see that file in the folder that it was created in. We press Control C to exit out of the running process, and we can do a ls on that folder. And you can see that there's the MinIO test bucket that we created. And inside that bucket, there is a MinIO test file. The last thing we're gonna do is install the MinIO client and connect to the local server. In order to do that, we'll need to bring the server back up and running. And we're gonna use a background command to run it in the background so that we can use the same console window. If you ever wanna exit the background command, you can just type FG and it will bring it back to the foreground, and you can hit Control C to actually exit the process. Next, we'll use wget to download the MinIO client, change the permissions to make it executable, and move it into our path at user local bin. We'll now set a MinIO client alias as local and attach it to the loopback address. Now we can see information about the local console running using the mcadmininfo-local command, local being the name of the cluster that we added. And we can also see the files located in here by running mcls-r. And we can see all of the different files that have been created in here, as well as the metadata and the zip file. Thanks for watching. Hopefully you have a good understanding of how to quickly get MinIO up and running on Debian-based systems now. If you'd like to learn more information, you can visit us at min.io, or you can join the conversation at minio.slack.com. Thanks and have a good one.